In this video, I'll show you some of the cool new features in Crossword Compiler 11.30, new features since 11.20. So firstly, there are a lot more grid patterns. So after choosing a grid size, there are now about twice as many grid patterns you can choose in the various different grid libraries. But apart from that, there's also a brand new feature, which is this button down here, Generate Patterns. So if you don't like any of the provided grid patterns, you can generate one to your specification. So if I click Generate Pattern, then I get this grid pattern generator window, and I can choose some various options here about how I want the grid to be generated. If I click Generate, it'll generate a new random grid given those settings. And I can click it again as many times as I like to get new settings. So this is for an American style grid. You can also generate cryptic or quick style grids. Or going back to American. There are a bunch of new symmetries introduced in this version. So this is normal symmetry, which is the standard symmetry used for grids in the papers. But you can also now do a bunch of new ones, including dual mirror and maximum here. So just to show you the effect of these symmetries, this is doing left and right symmetry. There's top and bottom symmetry. And now you have a dual mirror symmetry as well, which does both simultaneously. So this gives you a very symmetric grid that can also be used with rectangular puzzles. And there's also maximum symmetry, which gives these highly symmetric grid patterns. And then if you want to, you can change the settings here for the grids. If, for example, if you don't like these blocks in the corners, can turn off allow corner blocks. And if you don't like having consecutive blocks along the edge, you could turn that down to say one. So you can generate grid patterns to your specification. If you have a particular distribution of lengths you want to use, you can also expand the window using this lengths button. So let me just go back to normal symmetry. Let's say I wanted to have two 14 letter words and two 11 letter words. You can then click generate, and it will generate grids consistent with those. So you can click to see where the different words are. And this distribution gives you the full distribution of lengths that are produced in the grid. And of course, you can do the same thing for cryptic and quick. Sometimes, of course, it's not actually possible to do what you want to do given the constraints. There we are, now I have a pattern. When you've got a grid pattern that you like, you can just close this window to use it, or you can also add to the grid library if you want to and save the settings in this window for future use. So this way you can easily generate new patterns for whatever grid size you like. This is particularly useful if you're starting some new, slightly more unusual sized grid, including large ones. There is also a new way to view grid patterns in the new grid library manager down here on the grid library menu. So if I select Grid Library Manager, that opens this window here where I can see all the different grid libraries installed, all the different grid sizes in each library, and in each one all the different grid patterns. So here on the right you can see a preview, and you can also view the distribution of word lengths, number of words and blocks, and so on. You can also easily delete puzzles or open them. On the menu, there are a bunch of useful things for renaming patterns. For example, if I wanted to change all these patterns so they weren't named by the number of words and blocks, I could change the template here and it would rename all the grids in the library with this consistent pattern. This W and B are some placeholders. You can use different placeholders if you want to put things like the distribution of word lengths in the name. And that will just rename consistently everything in the grid library. You can also add grids from files, recursively add all the puzzles in a directory to add all their patterns to a grid library, merge grid libraries, remove grid libraries from other grid libraries, make new ones, copy them, and so on. For exporting, you can now export multiple grids simultaneously. If you go into the file menu, export multiple files, this gives you an option to select as many files as you like. So I wanted to export all these four grids simultaneously, click open, and it will now open the export window so you can simultaneously export as many puzzles as you like with the same settings. There's an equivalent setting for exporting web files. Web export convert files to applet files will produce files for the solving applet from a bunch of as many local files on your disk as you like. On the clue side, you can now add clues to a database from clues and squares puzzles. So if I go to add puzzle clues to database, you'll see that now I get the option to add all the clues that are in the clue squares in the puzzle as well as standard clues. The performance of the clue database has also been improved, and in the clue editor, there is now a new settings button here, so you can show the clue character count up here if you want to keep track of how long your clues are. There are some new options to control how clue answers are shown here in the preferences window. For example, if I want answers to appear uppercase for review, I can click that button there, and then they'll appear uppercase here. But you can also change the answers to uppercase for export as well, or for filling words in clue squares. So you can customize exactly where you want words to appear uppercase, or you can just leave the defaults and then words will show in their default case. In the Pro Grid Filler, the American word list has been updated here with new words, and on the Special tab, there's a new option to exclude words matching a particular pattern. So for example, if I wanted to make a special puzzle which had no letter E in, I'd have something E star, and that would exclude all words like that. If I click Fill, then it generates a fill without any letter E's in. The Pro Grid Filler's Fit Theme Words function also has a new option to use rebus letters. So for example, let's say I wanted to use the words pandemonium and wide-mouthed, both of which contain the letters demo in the middle. I could put demo in the rebus letters, and it would now find grids that can fit the two words using demo in a single square, like that. Images in the grid and background pictures for squares both now support new formats. SVG, a sort of scalable vector format, and WebP. WebP is useful, for example, for inserting images being generated by ChatGPT and other things. So Crossword King here is an image in the WebP format that I generated using ChatGPT. Then that can now insert that. WebP is just a pixel format, just like PNG or JPEG. This is fairly high resolution. SVG is scalable, so if you use a SVG image and then export to the web in a puzzle, that will scale perfectly. It's a vector format. The WebP is a new image format. Rather than opening the file, you can also now just drag and drop images onto the grid, and it'll open the insert image window automatically for you. There are many other features I haven't had time to go into. Just to end with some export and print options. There are now options when printing clues with answers to include the tags or explanations you can see on the right here. So that can be customized. There are a variety of new additional options for exporting in different formats and numerous miscellaneous changes to usability, bug fixes, etc. So that's all for this video. For a full list of changes, see the full history change log. Enjoy using the program.